Hi, my name is John. I want to share with you four primary attributes about Leyland cypress trees. Before we jump into this video, hit the like button. This helps us to get this video in front of a wider audience and help more people who love trees. Leyland cypresses are a good tree for providing a second story screen. You will commonly see them planted near a property line. We did a project with a large Leyland cypress hedge that had become too tall and wide and reduced sunlight to the adjacent understory plant material. One of the considerations with Leyland cypresses is to determine whether you're looking for a formal hedge or an informal hedge. A Leyland cypress, if sheared 1 to 2 times a year, can grow to become an extremely formal, large natural style fence. With a lower maintenance cycle, lateral pruning of every 2 to 3 years, the Leyland cypresses will generally have more of an informal look. Many homeowners prefer this over the formal hedge. However, there are some attributes you should be aware of. Attribute number one, they grow much faster in full sunlight growth patterns. Many times you'll see a row of Leyland cypress trees in which the trees at the end of the row are substantially larger due to the higher sunlight exposure. The trees that get more sunlight will grow in some cases 3 to 4 times larger than the trees that are in lower light conditions. Attribute number two, they can grow big. Leyland cypresses can grow big and create lots of shade. Many years ago, I had a master gardener from London, England, tell me an interesting story about the Leyland cypresses. She said the trees created enough social unrest in London that Parliament stepped in to create a law that required the trees to be reduced to a manageable height. Some countries are more passionate about their sunlight and gardens than others. In terms of ultimate growth pattern, some of the highest volume removals I have ever worked on were Leyland cypresses. I've seen them 2 to 3 times the cubic volume of an average 4-bedroom, 3-car garage home. I've also seen estates use growth suppressant hormones on this species to reduce maintenance costs. Attribute number three, dead zone expansion. As a Leyland cypress is permitted to grow taller and wider, the interior dead zone of the tree will expand. With other types of hedge material, such as an English laurel, the interior can regenerate if the interior loses its green foliage due to loss of light. In contrast, with Leyland cypresses, the dead zone expansion is irrevocable. The Leyland cypress will essentially cannibalize itself. As a tree grows taller and wider, it grows where it gets most of its sunlight, and sections die off where light conditions become incrementally darker. This attribute makes maintenance pruning very important on the Leyland cypresses. We recommend not allowing them to grow taller or wider than they need to provide the privacy screening. This is because the wider the hedge is, the more difficult and expensive it is to maintain. The taller the hedge is, it will create more shade for everything else around it. Attribute number four, they're prone for lateral weight load failure. This is especially pronounced when we get an occasional Puget Sound heavy snow. I want to touch on another important topic related to hedge management. Do you use a landscaper or a tree company to work on a medium to large Leyland cypress hedge? Well-meaning, hardworking, and we will call them courageous sole proprietor landscapers will sometimes offer to climb Leyland cypresses as a service to homeowners. Although a homeowner might feel they're getting a really good deal by doing so, I don't recommend that path. Because of Department of Labor industry regulations and insurance restrictions, established landscape firms will not allow the workers to go over 13 feet. In another video we did, we spoke about safety standards and practices and the dangers of gravity. Because Leyland cypresses can grow to be 18 feet, 28 feet, 38 feet or larger, gravity and the associated dangers are most certainly present. Working in large hedges have a different set of safe work practice protocols than other types of trees. For example, a large conifer with a primary vertical stem would allow a climbing technician to tie in at a high point and move laterally. A hedge generally does not offer that option. This can create a more hazard-prone working environment for an untrained technician. Typically, a sole proprietor landscaper working on a large hedge would do so without any type of climbing harness. Having landscapers working on a hedge and operate in an area where insurance does not cover without proper safety tools and equipment is, in my opinion, not prudent. If you need an arborist that can help you with your Leyland cypresses or other high canopy hedge style tree work, reach out to us on our website for a free consultation. If you're looking for more information on how to care for your trees, subscribe to our channel.